Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Imani. Thank you for tuning in. If you are new, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, do all the works, you know, all that good stuff. And we're gonna go ahead and right into this video because I know you guys don't like a drawn out intro. Neither do I. Anyway, so as you can tell by the thumbnail and by the title of this video, this is about how to start a successful YouTube channel in 2022. You guys kept getting on me about my 2020 video about how the music was so loud. So I figured I would go ahead and give you guys a revamped version of that video. Yeah, so let's go ahead and get into it.
Previously on.
So first things first, it's going to sound cliche as all get out, but the best way to start a successful YouTube channel is obviously to start. And I say that without you guys being like,
well, obviously.
But I mean that meaning like you took the first step and the first initiative to actually beginning your journey as a YouTuber. And it's a lot more difficult than it sounds. And most people don't understand that. But the fact that you even stopped and was like, okay, I'm ready to do this and take this jump and this leap, that is the best thing that you could do. However, here are some key points that I don't want you guys to do, which can essentially lead for you to burn out yourself. For one, don't feel like you have to have this daggone Real Housewives TV film set up right away. You do not. When I started my channel, maybe like at a channel 2013, a long time ago, I don't feel like doing the math. Basically what I thought was, oh, I had to have this elaborate setup and I need to make sure that I have all these expensive gadgets. No, that is not the case. I started off recording on my iPhone 4 for one, and not knowing that there was a camera setting in there that for you to be able to record in HD. I didn't even know that until maybe like 2017 or 2018, and that was just because I wanted bomb photos. But now that I know that, it's a tip that I can give you guys. So if you're recording on your phone, and especially if you have an iPhone now in 2022, you have a great camera. You don't have to go out and go to Best Buy and go buy these $800 cameras, these vlogging cameras. You don't have to do that. Your phone is just as good as these cameras, trust me. Just make sure that your camera settings are set to record in 4K, and that you can go out and go get these little ring lights for your phone, or you can just turn your flash on. That's another hack that's free. It comes with the phone. Well, it's not free because you pay for the phone, but it's free. It comes with the phone. So you can go get a stand. I feel like that's more on the inexpensive side as far as getting a stand for you to hold your phone. I started out with a whole bunch of shoe boxes and books and propping my phone up the best way I could with that. And that's something else that you guys can do. As far as recording on your phone, I do recommend recording on your back camera just to get the most effective and efficient quality, because it's always going to be quality over quantity. So definitely record with your back camera. And if you're not really sure like if you're in frame or not, just you can get like a wall mirror and put it in front of your phone. When I say in front, I meant like on the opposite side of your phone to make sure that you're always in frame. You can go get a ring light. Ring lights can get pretty pricey. The best thing that I would say is to use natural lighting. Natural lighting is always going to be your friend on YouTube no matter what. Next part, I know most people feel like, you know, I don't want to niche down. I don't want to be confined to one category. I want to do multiple things. That's fine. However, I will say for the algorithm and I know the algorithm almost sounds like a myth, but for the YouTube algorithm, for your audience, for yourself, it's best that you find a lane and stay in that lane, only so that way your audience can get to know you better. And why not start off with something that you genuinely love? Like, I get you can have a passion for a lot of things. However, find the passion that has like the biggest inspiration with you and stick with that for a while. And then I feel like you can slowly start introducing other things to your audience just to see, like, you know, the feedback from that. Because sometimes your audience may not like that. Or you can just do what most people do and create multiple YouTube channels for different things. However, I do feel like that's a lot, because it's not impossible for you guys to add on other categories. Like, for instance, my channel is Mom Life, Military, and Makeup. But, you know, majority of my videos on here are makeup. And from time to time, I'll dibble dabble in the other things if, you know, I get a random influx of questions about motherhood or the military or people just wanting to know how I achieve a makeup look. But definitely niche down, and in doing so, it'll just help you create a better schedule for yourself, which honestly goes into the next thing, is to make a schedule for yourself. So without a schedule, I feel like you can definitely burn yourself out, and you'll also never really understand the metrics of YouTube. When you create a schedule, you definitely start broadcasting yourself more, because it's healthy, because you know you know and your audience knows when you're going to upload and when you're going to, what time you're going to drop a new video. And those are the key things. I will say there is a sweet spot for YouTube with dropping a video, and it's normally around like 3 p.m. no matter what the day is of the week. So starting out, I would just do that. And so I will say start off with like maybe 3 videos a week. And I say that because, you know, you want YouTube to start pushing more of your content out. And the more content you push out, the more they can show to a wider range of audience, which also goes into search engine optimization. But I'm not going to go in and talk about that right now because that's a whole nother ballgame in itself. And if you would like for me to talk to you guys about that, I honestly feel like I have it down with a T, and I definitely feel like I can explain it way better than what YouTube's creator studio can. That sometimes they put on all these big fancy words, or they'll say do this, do that. No, it's as simple as 1, 2, 3, honestly. But I'm gonna save that for another video, and if you guys want me to make a video on that, just let me know in the comments down below. But definitely create a schedule for yourself, and when you start posting consistently like that, you will actually get some metrics back from YouTube, and YouTube will tell you, you know, hey, your audience is normally on at this time of day during this time of week, and these are the sweet spots that you should post on. And you should definitely listen to those because they would definitely have your audience captivated. However, most of the time I would say just stick with the normal schedule so your audience knows, hey, it's 3 p.m. I'm gonna go tune in. But once you start growing your audience, it's not really going to matter too much when you post, because if they love your content, they're going to tune in regardless. Next thing is beginner-friendly tools. Honestly, I started out on my iPhone, and obviously iMovie was a free part of that iPhone. So, and I still use it to this day. I don't use Filmora, or I think that's one of them. Splice. What's another one? Oh my gosh, there's one by Adobe. I just can't remember what it's called, but it's the most expensive one there can be. You can get those if you want to, if you have the money for that. But honestly, iMovie works just as good, especially starting out as a nano creator and just any creator at all. I definitely feel like it's easy because it's simple to walk through. Everything is right there for you as far as enhancing the background, green screens, enhancing your sound, reducing background noise, and then some. Everybody always messaging me as far as, you know, what software do I use to edit my film, and it's iMovie. There's so many hacks that you can do with it as well, and I definitely feel like for starting out, that is one of the ones that you can use. And that's all that I use. And even if you don't have a microphone right away, because most people don't, but iMovie allows you to, you know, adapt your sound and make it sound like you have a microphone without actually having one. So that's the best tools to use. Another tool that I will say as far as creating thumbnails goes is Canva. If you're not familiar with Canva, I will link it down in my description box. And honestly, Canva is so easy to use, whether you're creating ads. Like I said, I'm also a makeup artist. I'm going to take clients. So I use that for ads when I want to post stuff to let people know, like, hey, there's a deal going on, or hey, I have availability, blah, blah, blah. With Canva, they actually have templates that you can use for you to create a thumbnail. And that way you can stay consistent with creating a captivating thumbnail. However, I will say thumbnail creating is not easy. Some people have a natural knack for it. However, like I said, I've had my channel for so long, and literally this year I just discovered like what works best as far as creating a captivating thumbnail, so it can always change. I just learned recently like the best tools to use, honestly, for creating my thumbnails, and I'm still learning to this day, so I can actually do another video for that for you guys. I did it a while back, but I definitely want to redo it now and give you guys a more captivating response. I can only really assist the ones that are in the makeup community because that's solely what I focus on. But when I get it down packed, I promise you, everybody else, I got you. Another thing is do your research. So a lot of the time people just think, and it's actually not a problem that you want to post what you want to post, because ultimately it's your YouTube channel, so do what you want to do. However, I will say do your research as far as, you know, what's trending right now. And not saying that you have to follow trends, but I will say if you want to get more of attraction to your channel. Now, if you're just doing your channel just because you just feel like it's an outlet for you, by all means, you don't have to do any of these things. You don't. It's just a way for you to regroup. And so it's definitely ideal if you just have your channel just because you just want a channel. However, in this case where you're trying to make a lucrative income, or if you're trying to actually gain some traction and gain an audience, I definitely say do your research on what's trending, you know, the proper keywords to use, which I said that also goes into SEO. So I will actually end up making a video for you guys with that, because I definitely feel like there's other parts to YouTube. It's really the thumbnail, SEO, and making sure that you start off on the right foot on this channel. Oh, if I didn't say it already, please, 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 do do not do sub for sub. That's actually against YouTube's policy, and you can get shadow banned or they'll completely delete your page. Essentially, all it does is it shows YouTube like, hey, she has 2,000 or 50,000 subscribers, but she's only getting 3 views. So either this is a spam page, a bot page, or, you know, you did sub for sub, and it goes against community guidelines, and you will get your page basically taken away from you, or you'll just get blacklisted basically on YouTube. So I will say, with that being said, do not do sub for subs. It doesn't do anything for your channel. If you truly want to grow your channel, just start off with posting, and people will naturally go to your channel if they actually love your content. So stay authentic, be yourself, and don't worry about sub counts or views. Do your YouTube channel and make videos because you love to. It's always going to be quality over quantity, trust me, in every way. And I know I had just said it, but be authentic. I feel like the audience on YouTube, they're freaking amazing and kind of funny too, with being able to tell about if you're being fake or not with the content that you're posting. If you're just making content to mimic somebody else, now if you're an impersonator, that's that. But if you're just making content to impersonate somebody else, they're going to know, because especially if they watch that person too, it's like, hey, I feel like, you know, you're trying to be like XYZ and you're not them. Like, who are you really? Like, you don't have to do that. Now, it's okay to be inspired by these people, but be you. That's why people are going to come to your channel. They want to see you. That's why they're here. They're not here to go see Spider-Man. If they want to go see Spider-Man, they go see Spider-Man. So definitely just continue to be yourself and, you know, exude that. You know, you can share, you know, also you can be private too, but, you know, just be authentic, be yourself. You don't have to be anybody else. The last thing I'm going to say with this video, honestly, because all these key points are, I know they're going to be kind of self-explanatory and maybe cliche to some of you guys, but that's honestly how you grow your channel. That's from personal experience. But promote, promote, promote. If you don't believe in yourself, nobody else will believe in your content. So definitely make sure that you're always promoting. I don't have a Twitter, so I can't really say how to promote on there. But I will say, as far as Facebook and Instagram, with Instagram, which I'm glad they changed it, because years ago it used to be to where if you only had 10,000 followers, then you can have the swipe up feature to post your links. But now they have like the link button embedded in the stickers, so you can go ahead and, like, for instance, take your thumbnail or a clip from your video, post it to your story, and then, you know, copy your link from the video on YouTube, put it in that link, and, like, you know, have like a catchy catchphrase or tagline for the link saying, like, you know, tune in now, or you won't believe this, things like that. And, you know, post a sticker on there, and, you know, if you feel like, you know, your stories get a good amount of views, and don't be discouraged, because, you know, if you only get 35 views, after 35, you may get full 35 people who click on that link, or you might even get 10. It does not matter. It's the fact that you posted and that you're promoting your work, and people are going to see it. And most of the time, people are going to be like, I wonder what this is about, because she's always posting her channel. So, you know, continue to post your channel, and then you can post it to your feed. I don't necessarily do my feed that often, because I just feel like, as a makeup artist, for one, I have an aesthetic going on, and a lot of that is just my clientele based stuff, so I like to keep it that way. But I will post on my stories, and then in Facebook I am in a lot of groups, a lot. Not only do I post on my personal feed, but I also post in these groups if they allow it, because you know how some groups have their designated days and times, and that's okay, just respect those. But you can definitely go into these YouTube groups, you can go into these beauty groups, you can go into these gaming groups, whatever groups that you're actually into, or whatever you're trying to record for your channel, go into these groups and, you know, introduce yourself, introduce your channel, you know, drop a link if they allow you to drop links, you know, things of that nature. And, you know, let that be that. Don't get discouraged if they don't let you drop links, because some of them don't, but that's okay. As long as you're posting and promoting, somebody's going to see that you have a channel. People are going to see it, whether it's on YouTube, Facebook, Google, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, if you still use that, Kick, if you still use that. I feel like I just showed my age with Kick, but things of that nature. So, you know, still utilize those features as far as promoting. And honestly, guys, that's the main points that I wanted to hit for you guys in this video. I will be dropping some more as far as SEO and, you know, creating a thumbnail for your YouTube channel. I'll even create banners if you want me to. But right now, I just want to really focus on the SEO and the thumbnail portion. So I will say again, thank you guys for tuning in. Make sure you subscribe, like, comment, especially comment, because let me know what you guys want to, you know, see more of or hear more of. If you have any questions about this, as far as, you know, what my setup is or what I use, or, you know, what are the best things to use starting out, whether it is in regards to beauty, I can definitely give you guys a more in-depth video on, you know, how to start a successful beauty channel in 2022. So definitely let me know down in the comments down below, and I will see you guys next time.